When I came to Cambridge, Bragg was the connection with, yes, with James, you see, from the old days. And so Bragg, I thought I wanted to do something in the structure of matter, but something unusual, not straightforward crystallography. And one of the things I thought of joining was the MRC unit, which I'd heard, because there was correspondence between between Bragg and James, which he was sometimes telling me about.
Yes.
About the wonderful things they're doing at the MRC, the one thing they might be able to do at the MRC. And I remember a letter in which Bragg wrote to James, and he said, we now have Kendrew. Kendrew has now got good crystals of myoglobin. So this was a stable companion to haemoglobin, which Perutz was working on, which was in living for. And so Bragg said, we probably have a good choice here, being able to compare the two structures. I remember very clearly.
Yes.
So I asked Bragg. Bragg said the unit was full. Now, to this day, I don't know whether that's true or not. I have a feeling it's not. I think they either I wasn't regarded as either reliable, or there'd been somebody from Cape Town several years before me who turned out to be a dud. And maybe they thought that James's recommendation was faulty. So Bragg wanted me to work. I said I'd be happy to work on alloys, order disorder phenomena and alloys, uphill diffusion and so on. But Bragg said they were shutting that down, a man called Hargreaves. And what he wanted me to do, he was trying to direct me to work on silicates, order disorder in silicates. Well, I didn't find that interesting. I think I would now, but I didn't have enough, didn't know enough to know that it was a fascinating problem, but just as well. And so I spent 6 weeks, my first 6 weeks in Cambridge were sent. Letters would take 2 weeks because the boat, there was no airmail, and the ship took 2 weeks from Southampton to Cape Town. So, and there were no telephones. So for 6 weeks, I was hanging around wondering what to do. But James had said, go and see my old Manchester colleagues. There was the whole Manchester mafia in Cambridge. There was Leonard Jones, professor of chemistry, of theoretical chemistry. There was Hartree, professor of mathematical physics. And I went to see them both. And I'd actually done some work on quantum chemistry. I actually calculated the bond lengths. It's quite, you know, if you know some quantum mechanics, you can teach yourself molecular orbitals and valence bond theory, and I'd calculated it. So he offered me a PhD and with support in chemistry. But Hartree was the one who I decided to work with, because he had a problem which he thought he wanted a crystallographer. It was a problem in the phase transitions in steel, during the cooling of steel, a problem left over from the war. I think I better not talk too much about it, but it was it'd take too long. It was a led nowhere, but I learned a great deal. First of all, I learned to compute, originally by hand with a Brunswick, and later I used EDSAC. I was one of the first users of EDSAC. It was the first process control with a store unit. It was really the first of its kind.
Yes.
And I do remember on one night, because you could compute at night when there was less pressure on it, meeting John Kendrew, who was rather John Kendrew's wife, bringing him some a thermos flask and sandwiches to last the night.
Yes.
Just quite a romance, you see. I wasn't a nerd. Like, there were these guys, these computer guys who, you know, we now call nerds. They weren't called that in those days, but they would hang around all night and sleep during the day. John Kendrew wasn't, but that was the, it was quite fun. We had, it was all done with paper tapes and so on. And so I learned a great deal there. But I was solving partial differential equations together with chemical change.
And there was no time sharing when you, either one of you was using the machine or the other?
On EDSAC?
Yes.
Oh no, there was no time. You had to wait, your tapes yes. You had to get into a queue.
Yes.
Then you had to run your tapes. And you also had, in those days, you had what were called post-mortem tapes. So if something went wrong, you could interrogate the contents of the store. So it was all quite, quite interesting.